Hello, this is Dr. Heidelberg, and our presentation today relates to machine learning in mechatronics. We'll start with the definition. We'll take a look at the need, the immediate machine learning applications. We'll talk about the development process, see how we get started, and we'll give an example of machine learning for Fukushima turbine. The definition of machine learning, as shown by Expert System, is that it is an application of artificial intelligence that provides systems the ability to automatically learn and improve from experience without being explicitly programmed. The need, according to Dr. Claus of University of Tennessee, is to be able to have the ability to apply big data and analytics to practical applications for daily use. The reason why it became so popular is because of availability of big data storage in a cloud, increased computing powers, connectivity between the things with Internet of Things, investment in smart sensors and signal processing. He also recommends that we should take an opportunity to have and engage the millennials in this type of activities. We see that immediate applications, according to IBM today, is solving business challenges, creating new value for manufacturing data, improving product quality, enhancing knowledge management. This will result in minimizing downtime equipment, $100,000 for a downtime in many corporations, and then maximize production throughput. To get started, we can choose any one of these providers. The IBM provides it on Watson, providing the connectivity through Maximo between the machine and the cloud. Amazon provides on Amazon website service. We have here the process of building, training, and deploying models. You click on that and you get started. Google provides also free trials within the cloud machine learning engine. You build it and deploy it. And what we'll be using is Microsoft Azure, where you build, train, and deploy machine learning models with a free account. You can get started right now with 12 months free services. Some of the services stay on forever. You just click on that icon in this website, and you could register and get started. The Azure Machine Learning Studio that you get started should be trained within a couple of hours by watching these videos. And then the process is rather simple by dragging and dropping various application modules into the work area. You start by bringing in a data set. You could either create a model for yourself for trial or bringing it from your components that you are monitoring through the web. You select the columns that you like to analyze within this data. Then you split the data into two parts. One part goes to train the model, and you select over here from many tools the way you would like to train it. Typically, it's a linear regression. We'll see an example in a minute. Once you train the model, you could score the model with the other set of data, and what the model will do is will take the relationship that you find within the training and apply to the other set and see how well the predictive values fit the actual values. Once you have that done, you could evaluate the model and find out the correlation between the parameters that you were looking for. Here's an example of a Fukushima turbine generator data set taken from the internet. There is a timestamp on a table. There is the pressure sensing input. There's the turbine speed, turbine generator shaft vibration, and many other parameters. In this experiment, we were looking for a correlation between the turbine speed and shaft vibration, which may mean that there is an issue with the turbine if the vibrations are getting to be too high. So what we did is we ran the data set through the Microsoft Azure Machine Learning Studio. And what you see here is the correlation between the turbine speed and the vibration of the shaft. So you see that this is a statistical value, but we could provide a regression line, and then on a web application that we get by one click, we could then allow the user or our expert system to come in with a shaft vibration and a turbine RPM and come out with the prediction of the shaft vibration and decide whether it's safe or perhaps requiring a maintenance program. This completes our presentation. We'll use it in our upcoming experiment. Thank you.